I'm often asked about the word legacy. I mean, the ministry is called legacy-minded men, so you would think I would, naturally hear that a lot. What actually is legacy? And as I travel around, what I find is so many people don't even know what, I've never heard the word legacy, and others have a different idea of what it is. Well, legacy by definition is anything that we leave behind. So when you think about leaving a legacy for another generation or for another person, a lot of times people associate it with leaving money behind or property behind, which again is part of the definition. But when we talk about legacy, we look at it a little bit differently. You see, we believe it's that which is inside us that we're leaving behind. And for legacy-minded men specifically, we say transforming lives by engaging, encouraging, and equipping men to build a Christ-centered legacy, Christ-centered. What that means is very simple. It's not about us. It's not about you. It's all about the power of Christ in you, and that we want to share that with our children, with our children's children, with the people that we come in contact with. You see, at the end of the day, legacy is not about what we leave to others, it's about what we leave in others, because that's the only thing you could ever take with you. All the other things, the money and the property and the cars, you can't take that stuff with you. But what you can take with you is an eternity with Christ because of what's in you. You see, that power that we're sharing, that Christ-centered legacy, is all about knowing Him as Lord and Savior. And when we know Him as Lord and Savior, He comes within us and deposits the Holy Spirit. And that Holy Spirit is the power that gets released through us, in us first, and then through us. The problem in the world today, though, is that we have put a cap on the power of that spirit. And we have not allowed him to do all that he could do flowing through us. And how do I know that? Because look at the world. If all those that claim to be Christian allow the power of the spirit to flow through them, the world doesn't look this way. But it does. We're in chaos. We're challenged, and we know who the author of chaos is. So I want you to think about the word legacy, and I want you to think about where you are today. If you died today, what is the legacy you leave behind? Is it just merely a few nice words at a eulogy, or is it something that will carry on for generations to come? You're in control of that. Your attitude towards this particular topic and this particular question will dictate how the next generations will see you, and how the next generations will look at Christ. My name is Joe Pellegrino, and this has been a Legacy Minute.